It seems anthropology is everywhere these days. And that's no coincidence, because anthropologists are everywhere these days. Anthropology is the study of us. Our clothes, our homes, our bodies, how we talk and how we think. Our past, present, and future. It's all anthropology. The American Anthropological Association has created a video series to showcase how anthropologists are tackling the world's most pressing problems and making remarkable contributions to human understanding.
Death doesn't happen 9 to 5, Monday through Friday. It happens all the time.
A lot of the times, the phone will ring and I'm dead asleep. They'll tell me, you know, it's a 35-year-old with a single gunshot wound to the head and there's a note on the scene, so it's probably a suicide.
I'm a death investigator and a forensic anthropologist. Forensics is anything relating the law and science together. So when we apply the law to anthropology, that basically means we're using our knowledge of human osteology and kind of applying that to the law. The purpose of a medical examiner's office is to determine cause and manner of death.
It's my job when I go out to the scene and when I'm asking questions on the phone of family members, doctors, law enforcement, is basically to rule out everything else. And I do that with the specific questions that I ask.
And this is where kind of the anthropology training comes into play. So I'm gonna ask cops specific questions and look for specific answers. Whereas with the families, they just lost a loved one, you know? So you have to change your tone. You have to change the language that you're using when you're speaking to them. I've always wanted to do more of the forensic science side than be a professor of anthropology or work kind of in a traditional anthropology role. I was a researcher for the World War II Directorate, and we went back and recreated the last known whereabouts and the circumstances of the loss of folks from World War II service personnel. One of the very first Battle of the Bulge fights, they took some shots from the German soldiers, the boat went down, they couldn't positively identify this gentleman. His name is Private Bain. So they buried him as an unknown, and there he stayed for 60 years. Being trained in forensic anthropology, I went back in his records and was able to kind of recreate everything, and they had made a mistake. His dental report said that he was missing one of his molars, but the original, when he first entered the army, they had said that he was missing a different molar. Doing that identification with Bain was kind of just a touch and a taste of using what I know to provide closure to a family, and I knew that's what I wanted to do. A good thing about an anthropology degree, it provides you with kind of this broad overview of human beings. People are scared of death. In the United States, we are so reverent. A lot of the times we ignore it. And that's a very American thing to do, right? Just ignore it and it'll go away. But everyone dies, and I think it's important to find out why and what happened. It's respectful to the person and to their family so they know. I do this job because it's the worst day of people's lives and I can do it. Somebody has to help these families and figure out why their loved one is deceased. I'm glad to do it, and it encompasses all the things that I love to do.